let's look at some of the common failure modes of turbochargers. Most failures in turbochargers have nothing to do with the turbo itself, but are caused by peripheral components or system failures. You should refer to an OE service manual for additional diagnostic information. And if you are a do-it-yourselfer, please seek the help of a professional technician to help you determine the root causes of these issues. If the root cause is not remedied, it will affect the performance and longevity of your replacement unit as well. Most turbocharger failures are caused by the following issues: improper lubrication, exhaust contamination, soot, fuel, particulate, damaged engine components or restriction in the exhaust system, contaminated air supply, sand, bolts, clips, filter material or shop rag in the air intake. Before installing the replacement turbocharger, you need to find the root cause of failure to prevent the replacement unit from failing. Here is the turbocharger inspection procedure. 1. Visually inspect the original turbocharger, checking for cracks, leaks, or evidence of exhaust leaks. Inspect the compressor and turbine wheel for any nicks, chips, or missing blades that were damaged by foreign objects. 2. The turbine and compressor wheels must spin freely when turned by hand. If either wheel contacts the housing or the wheels do not rotate smoothly, it indicates a worn bearing, typically caused by improper oil lubrication. And 3, check the wheels and shaft for excessive axial end play. Move the wheels and shaft in and out, checking for 2,000ths to 5,000ths end play. Any play exceeding 5,000ths, the thickness of a sheet of paper, indicates a worn thrust bearing due to excessive exhaust back pressure.